Hello students, welcome back. Today we are going to discuss the third module of chapter 2. The name of the chapter is The Tale of Peter Rabbit. By the end of today's class, you will be able to read and enjoy the complete story to enrich your English vocabulary. To help students learn that it important to obey their parents. Dear students, we already have started the chapter, The Tale of Peter Rabbit. In the first two module, we have discussed the story of four little bunnies, and among them, Peter Rabbit is a little bit naughty, and this story is about one of his accident that happened in MacGregor's garden. So as we all know that Peter Rabbit is stuck in the garden, let's see, will he able to escape from the garden? What will happen to him? Let's see. So, before moving on to our story, let's listen to some new words meaning which you may feel unfamiliar or little bit difficult. Wheelbarrow, a small cart used in gardens to carry things. Wheelbarrow. Next word is hoeing, digging. Meaning is digging. The word is hoeing. In the picture itself, it's very clear what is the meaning of the word hoeing. Next word is darted, moved suddenly. Darted, moved suddenly. The next word is sneaked out. Sneaked out. The meaning of the word is moved out quickly. Moved out quickly. Then last but not least, flopped down. The word is flopped down. Fell down heavily because he was tired. Flopped down means fell down heavily because he was tired. Now let's move on to the chapter and see what happened to Peter Rabbit. Let's begin. A mouse ran in and out over the stone doorstep, carrying peas for her family. Peter asked her the way to the gate. She had such a large pea in her mouth that she could not answer. She only shook her head at him. Peter began to cry. When our Peter Rabbit was very tired and sitting in front of the door, a mouse came in front of him and he was carrying pea for her family. At that time, Peter asked him, "Can you help me? Can you tell me the way to the gate?" But she, in her mouth, she was stuck with pea, so she cannot answer. She, what did she do? She shook her head at him. When he saw that, our Peter began to cry. Peter now heard the noise of a hoe. Scritch, scratch, scritch. Peter darted underneath the bushes. When nothing happened, he came out, climbed on a wheelbarrow, and peeked over the edge. He saw MacGregor hoeing onions. His back was turned towards Peter, and beyond him was the gate. Now let's see, what is he doing? Now Peter heard a noise of a hoe scratching the mud. So what did he do? He moved quickly under the bushes. When nothing happened, he came out of the bush and climbed on a wheelbarrow and peeped over the edge. he was looking over the edge, he saw Mr. McGregor hoeing onions. He was planting onions. He was taking out onions. His back was turned towards Peter. So, beyond McGregor, he saw the gate. He wanted to escape. Peter sneaked out of the wheelbarrow and started running as fast as he could go. Mr. McGregor caught sight of him. Peter did not care. He slipped underneath the gate and started running. So what did Peter do? Peter sneaked out. He moved out quickly of the wheelbarrow and started running as fast as he could. With his maximum speed, he tried to escape from the garden. McGregor see him, but Peter did not care about him, and he slipped below the gate and he started to run to his home. Peter never stopped running or looked behind him till he got home to the big fir tree. He was so tired that he flopped down upon the soft floor of the rabbit hole and shut his eyes. His mother later wondered what he had done with his clothes. It was the second jacket and pair of shoes that Peter had lost in a fortnight. So here, when Peter escaped from the garden, he never stopped running. He didn't turn to look back. He started to run till he reached home. He ran as fast as he could. And what did he do? When he reached his home, he flopped down. That means he fell down because he was too tired. When his mother saw him lying, his mother was thinking. She was wondering what he have done with his clothes. He is not having his clothes and shoes. Why? What happened to his clothes, his jacket and his shoes? He lost it in Mr. McGregor's garden. So this was the second jacket and pair of shoe that Peter had lost in the fortnight. Fortnight means 2 weeks of 14 days. Here comes an end to the story of Peter Rabbit. So the moral of the story is, we should listen to our parents' advice. Here we can see that Peter Rabbit didn't listen to his mother. That's why he came to met with some troubles in McGregor's garden. Dear students, hope you all have understood the story. The follow-up activity is this: read and revisit the story once again, and let's meet in our classroom.